Good morning, this is Manoj Kumar Jain and welcome you all in IndiaNivesh Commodity Research Update. Gold and silver prices shows a strong run up in yesterday's session after Chinese coronavirus outbreak and sell-off in global equities. We have seen safe haven buying in both the precious metals again. Dollar index also sees profit taking at higher levels and also supports the prices of both the precious metals in international market. And due to the weakness in rupee, we have seen supports in both the precious metals prices in domestic markets. Gold prices there's the crucial resistance level of $1,584 per troy ounce in international markets, and silver prices also test the $18 per troy ounce odd levels in international market in yesterday's session. Even in domestic market, gold prices made a high of 41,068 and silver prices also test the highs of 46,966 at MCX in yesterday's session. But after WHO praised China for handling coronavirus outbreak, we expect some profit taking in both the precious metals at higher levels in today's session. Gold prices could again test the supports level of $1,564-$1,562 odd per troy ounce in international market, while silver prices could again test the supports level of $17.80-$17.55 per troy ounce in international markets. 18.18 acts as a major resistance for silver in international markets. Even in domestic market, gold prices could again test $40,800-$40,680 odd levels, while 41,100 acts as a major resistance for gold in domestic markets, while silver prices could test the 46,600 to 46,400 odd levels in domestic markets. 47,100 acts as a resistance for silver in domestic markets. Crude oil prices also shows the weakness in yesterday's session and breached the crucial support level of $52 per barrel in international market, as we have already mentioned in our earlier view that the crude prices could test $52 per barrel in international market. Prices traded in pressure due to the Chinese outbreak and fear of slower global crude oil demand. However, OPEC countries are expected to meet and could further cut the production to support the global crude oil prices. We expect the $52 per barrel could be held on a weekly closing basis in today's session, and some short covering is expected after WHO's statement, and prices could again test $53 to $53.5 per barrel in international markets. Even in domestic market, 3717 is held on a closing basis in yesterday's session, and we expect the prices could again approach towards its resistance level of 3,720 in domestic markets. 3,690 acts as a major support for crude oil prices in domestic markets. Base metal prices continue to show weakness as copper prices slipped to record low at London Metal Exchange in yesterday's session and made a high of $5,565 per metric ton, as we have already mentioned in our earlier remark that copper prices could test the lows of 5,550 in international markets. Even in domestic market, prices slipped below 430 odd levels and test the lows of 427 in yesterday's session. After WHO remark, we expect some short covering in the copper prices, and prices could again test the resistance level of $5,620 to $5,650 per metric ton at LME, and could test the $430 to $432 odd levels in domestic markets. Nickel prices are trading in a range, and till the prices are trading in the range of 922 on the lower side, 955 on the higher side, we expect prices remain trade in a indicative range. Either side breakout of the range will give the further direction to the prices. Other base metals are also traded in a range. However, zinc prices shows a further weakness of around 1% in yesterday's session. We expect a short covering in entire base metal pack in today's session, and prices could again test the immediate resistance level in today's session. In agriculture commodities, we have seen selling pressure in yesterday's session in entire agriculture commodity spec. Bursa Malaysia again tumbled due to the fear of lower export demand from China, and India has already put the Malaysian palm oil on restricted import category list. Bursa Malaysia again slipped more than 100 points in yesterday's session, and pressure is also seen in domestic CPO, refined soya oil and soybean prices. CBOT, refined soya oil and soybean future is also slipped in yesterday's session and put pressure on the domestic oil, edible oil and oilseeds prices. Refined soya oil is now having a strong support of 842 and expected to be hold, and if the prices sustain above 860 odd levels, could extend the rally towards 866 levels again. Soybean prices are holding a support level of 4,015 domestic market, and 4,110 is the immediate resistance, and only prices sustain above this level could extend the rally towards 4,155. 4,040-4,008 is a major support for soybean in domestic markets. Other agriculture commodities also shows the pressure in yesterday's session. Guar seed, guar gum, castor seed, chana, cotton seed, oil cake, and entire spices peg shows weakness in yesterday's session due to the fear of lower export demand. We expect some bargain buying in guar seed and guar gum prices in today's session, and some buying could also be seen in the cotton prices at lower levels. Ahead of union budget tomorrow, we expect the volatility remain continue in entire agriculture and other commodities peg in domestic markets. We suggest trader to trade with strict stop losses in today's session. For more updates on agriculture commodities and other commodities research, keep watching IndiaNivesh research update on Telegram channel. Thank you.